Welcome to FARview, the podcast series of the Foundation for Auditing Research. In this podcast, we interview academics and professionals regarding the practical relevance of academic research in the field of auditing. The Foundation for Auditing Research is an autonomous institute focused on developing and disseminating scientific knowledge concerning audit quality in the Netherlands. FAR pursues these objectives by facilitating relevant and rigorous academic research through a unique collaboration between academia and audit practice.
Dear podcast listeners, today our special conference guest is Tjibbe Bosman. Tjibbe is one of the authors of a paper that just got accepted in Current Issues in Auditing. The title of the paper is Robotic Process Automation for the Extraction of Audit Information, a Use Case. Tjibbe, welcome and congratulations with your publication. Maybe to start off, for the people who don't know you, you can tell a bit about yourself and your affiliation with FAR.
Thanks, Luc. Well, my name is Tjibbe Bosman, 31 years old. I'm affiliated with FAR for the last 2.5 years. Besides FAR, I am also a PhD candidate at the University of Amsterdam. And at FAR, I'm pretty much the data program manager. And there I work together with the research teams and also with the audit firms to make sure that they understand each other, they communicate with each other, and the data gets delivered for the high quality research projects. And that's also how we came to this project. So there was a call for papers by Current Issues in Auditing on collaborations between practice and academia in auditing. And we were working together with Jeroen Bellinga and Ala Kazam from PwC on the development of a piece of Python code, a piece of programming code to automate certain steps. And we used that code for the data collection that we do at the Foundation for Auditing Research, and they could apply and tweak that programming code to really apply that on real-life audit engagements. And we thought that, okay, this could actually be interesting.
Why did you need that?
Yeah, so it's a good question. There are currently over 30 research projects at the Foundation for Auditing Research, and they all need data of some sort. And a lot of them also need data from publicly available sources. So that means pretty much gathering data from annual reports. And in the Netherlands, that are just PDFs that come from the trade register. So we have big piles of PDFs, and we need to make structured, high-quality research data out of that for the research teams. So we do that with research associates, pretty much students who work part-time for the foundation, to help us out in gathering those data. But that's, of course, not that scalable. So then we started investigating from, okay, how could we scale that up? And wouldn't it be possible to automate part of that? And that's how we came to robotic process automation for really extraction of those data from annual reports. And we discussed kind of the project and the steps we were taking with Jeroen of PwC. And he said, well, that could actually be useful for some of my clients and some of the projects I'm working on, and also for a more general purpose. So why not work together and see how we can apply it? And we said, well, we can do that, but then we want to publish it open source so it would be available for everybody. Okay. And that's what we did.
Okay. So, but it was also a FAR research project in itself, right?
Yeah, almost. So the data gathering was for kind of a large number of projects. So a lot of projects want to gather data on the audits that certain auditors perform, and we can get those data from public sources. So that was pretty much the starting point. And it was also the starting point in how we were collaborating together with Jeroen. And then we were discussing from pretty much the challenge we have with scaling it up and with automating as much as possible. And Jeroen pointed out from, okay, we have a pretty similar situation when we audit, for an example, a big asset management company. And there you have sometimes even more than 100 financial statements, and you want to automate the data extraction of those PDFs to some digital format to make it easier to reconcile information to the accounting information system. Mm-hmm. And usually he would have kind of large teams with young assistants who just came from university and help him with that. But this year he got Ala, who was pretty much fresh at PwC. But Ala has coding experience and also used to lecture at the university in Syria. So Jeroen said, okay, well, that would be quite a waste of resource, right? To take Ala and say, okay, well, just reconcile this to that the next 2 weeks. Let's see if we can work together and make this more efficient and actually make a tool that could help practice and also academia for the data collection. Mm-hmm. And that's how we start working together. My colleague Wim Jansen did a very important part of the programming of the script, of the algorithm. And we have Seyit Hotchuk of Center Data who really helped us out in reviewing the code in making sure that it's on GitHub, it's accessible for everybody, that it's clearly written up, debugging stuff.
So don't tools like this exist already?
Yes, there are of course tools like this. We also go into that in the paper. For example, kind of these standard software solutions from Adobe and other providers. But if we looked at those tools, and if you extract that data from a PDF to Excel, there are a couple of disadvantages. One is that you need to pay a fee, usually for the pro license, so it costs a little bit of money. But also that batch processing is quite hard. So in a situation where you're auditing an asset manager or a fund or something, and they have over 100 financial statements that all need to be audited, you need to then click 100 times, and you want to automate that as much as possible.
Mm-hmm. So it is, in that sense, it's new that it's freely available for everybody.
Yeah, so, I mean, in the technique, not so much is new over there. Mm-hmm. It's what we pretty much did is take existing techniques from data science and apply it in the auditing setting and write it up how we did it and also make our code available for everybody who would like to use it.
So how will this develop further? Do you have more plans for this, or is it done like it is right now? Or?
So this part, it's pretty much out there in the open. So it's out there for everybody who would like to use it or apply it. And we are, of course, developing it further to see how we can automate the data collection process from publicly filed financial statements to make big sets of financial statements and high-quality data accessible for researchers in a cost-efficient manner.
So this already saved a lot of time for the FAR studies also, or?
Yeah, absolutely, and also for the audit firms. Yeah. So it was really a win-win, and that's why we also reacted to the request for papers of current issues in auditing. And mm-hmm. We thought, okay, this is practitioner-oriented, we really work together on this, and it might be useful.
So maybe you can tell a bit more, well, we don't have a lot of time left, but about the journal where it is published. Maybe not everybody knows the journal.
So current issues in auditing, it's a practitioner-oriented journal. So quite short articles. I think it's comparable to the Maandblad Accountancy en Bedrijfseconomie in the Netherlands. It also has practitioner summaries. Yeah. So sometimes you have a very detailed, a very theoretical, more fundamental study. And then current issues in auditing would publish a practitioner summary of it, and also some issues that are currently relevant for audit practice. I think that also aligns with a lot of the goals that the foundation has, and that's where we choose that.
Okay, so that would leave something important out, Tjibbe. Of course, we're going to add the links to this later, so people can look it up and look at the software themselves, I guess.
Yeah, of course. I mean, we're interested in all the feedback, mm-hmm. whether the tool is useful in practice or whether there are questions or whatsoever. We also published a manual of the algorithm, We will be working with it, and we look forward to hear from everybody whether it was useful or not.
Okay. So maybe from your own experience, do you have an advice for the collaboration between practitioners and academics?
I think what is important to have fun together. If you really have the feeling that you're in it together and that you are working towards a common goal, it's actually quite funny to really do that as a team, because it brings really different perspectives from both sides, and I think it's valuable for everybody in a collaboration. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you very much, Tjibbe.
Thanks, Luke.
Enjoy the conference.
Yeah. Take care.